Now, the difference in this and my mom is that she would have used a stick of butter, okay? But I'm going to go ahead and put the onion in. And then I have some ketchup. And you know, it's like, oh gosh, if you're making it, you know what's in it, right? It's super easy. So now I'm going to add Worcestershire sauce. And a little bit of brown sugar. And apple cider vinegar. I love this barbecue sauce. And it will keep for weeks in a refrigerator because it has enough acid. Is everybody having a good time in Atlanta?
Yes. Yes.
Have y'all been having some good weather? I actually just came in from the airport. So it's a little cool. Atlanta's really nice when it starts to get sort of fallish. Now I'm gonna add some black pepper, and depending on your family's taste, you may wanna add a little bit more or a little bit less. I like a little bit of kick of brown pepper. And then finally at the end, I'm gonna add some Dijon mustard. And I use Dijon mustard, but you could also use a regular American mustard. Right? Doesn't it smell good? So then this is my favorite part because I wanted to make meatballs, but most of the time meatballs are bound with breadcrumbs. Mm-hmm. So my goal with this book was not just to make things lower in fat, okay? Because the other, like, what would happen, what would I need to do to increase the nutritional density of the recipes? Not just make them lower in fat. Now, having said that, on a side note, in this book, like I said, I'm using quinoa instead of breadcrumbs. And that is going to act just as a binder, and I have it pre-cooked. What I do, it's much in the way that the thought process goes with using the crock pot is like, I make batches of grains at the beginning of the week. Like I'll cook off a couple of cups of farro. I'll cook off a couple. Okay. And I'm gonna show y'all how to chop this onion just real quickly. So what I normally would do, of course, is to start with a whole onion. Let's have our pretend glasses on. So we have a whole onion, and then the first thing I do is I cut off the stem end and I leave on that root end, okay? The root end is what's holding it all together. I don't know about you, but I need everything I can do to have it all held together, right? Mm-hmm. So we're gonna take off this first layer of outside skin, and then this is where you start thinking, like, you wanna look at the blade, not the knife, and not the board, okay? And you wanna look to keep your knife even. Mm-hmm. Now, the second thing I want you to consider is, don't put the tips of your fingers on that onion. Put the pad of your palm. Because if that knife slips, you're